we want to simplify the given expression using our rules for exponents given here. Looking at our fraction, it may be tempting to try to simplify this fraction, but we can't do that because notice how the numerator is raised to the fourth power and the denominator is raised to the fifth power. So we can't simplify the fraction until we first apply this property of exponent that says if we have a power raised to a power, we multiply the exponents. So in the numerator, we will multiply each exponent inside the parentheses by 4. So we'd have x to the power of 4 times 4, or 16. Y to the power of 3 times 4, which is y to the 12th. And then z to the power of 5 times 4, which would be z to the 20th. Then in the denominator, since we have a power of 5 here, we're going to multiply every exponent inside the parentheses by 5. Before we do that, we need to recognize that this would be z to the first. So we'd have x to the power of, this would be 4 times 5, that's 20. Y to the power of 2 times 5, that would be 10. And then z to the power of 1 times 5, which would be z to the fifth. Now we'll look at this in three parts. We'll look at the x part, y part, and then z part. And because we have a quotient with the same base, we'll be subtracting our exponents using this rule here. Notice how we'll have the exponent of the numerator minus the exponent of the denominator. So we'll have x to the power of 16 minus 20, that's negative 4. Y to the power of 12 minus 10, that's 2. And then z to the power of 20 minus 5, that's 15. Now we're almost done, but we cannot leave the expression in this form. An expression is not considered simplified if it contains negative exponents. So for the last step, we'll apply. So for the last step, we'll use the rule that a to the power of negative m is equal to 1 over the power of a to the positive m. The way I view this rule is, if you make this into a fraction, it'd be over 1. So if something crosses a fraction bar, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So if we were to put this over 1, if we move this down to the denominator, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So we would have y to the second, z to the 15th in the numerator, and our denominator would be x to the power of positive 4. And now this expression is considered completely simplified.